worst mistake my heart ever made, even though it would cost me my life at just 17. It wasn't love at first sight. Yazidis shy away from strangers, especially where I lived in the Mosul region. There were Muslims and a few Christians, but we didn't dare mix. It's 10 years since the fall of Saddam. And no one is safe. No one's in control. And no one trusts anyone. My people have never been safe. For centuries, we Yazidis have been persecuted by Sunni Muslims who never tried to understand us. Yusuf carried the false myths about my people slung across his shoulders like his AK-47 rifle. Muslims and Christians believe Yazidis, we call ourselves Ezidi, are devil worshippers. And they also fault us for believing that we're descended from Adam and not Eve. So is it any wonder we cling to our own? I understand why outsiders see us as haughty and clannish, but we don't worship the devil. Yet my family looked at Yusuf as if he was the devil. Young, handsome, with a disarming smile, he spoke perfect Kurmanji in a smooth lisp that teased me like a serpent's tongue. I was a 17-year-old girl, a closely guarded virgin. How could I resist? Yusuf cast a spell on me from the moment we met.
Thirsty? It's cold. And you're hot. What would it hurt to drink a Coke with me? My name is Yusuf, and I'm not going to hurt you, I promise. You see, I vowed to do at least one good deed a day. And you look like you're melting. I have two cold Cokes. I didn't open them. I swear on the Quran.
Thank you. No. I must go. Goodbye.
Suit yourself. I'll just pour your Coke on the ground.
No! No!
I know all the Yazidi superstitions. Like don't spit or pour liquid on the ground. You're afraid of offending your spirit ancestors, aren't you?
Then you also know we don't associate with strangers. Or accept food nor drink from them.
I'm not a stranger. You know my name.
I know you're not Yazidi. And I don't like Coke. I prefer coffee for the caffeine.
Well, there's plenty of caffeine and Coke as well. Anyway, it was nice meeting you. Pleasure was all mine. This time.
But the pleasure was all mine too. No boy, no man had ever taken an interest in me as a woman. In my sheltered world, I had to be protected at all costs to safeguard the family honor. But of course, that just made me more curious about tasting forbidden fruit. Didn't Adam partake of a forbidden apple in the Garden of Eden? And wasn't I, an Yazidi, a direct descendant of Adam and not Eve? Playing it safe, I took a different route home from school the next day, only to encounter Yusuf on another empty road.
I hope you drink your coffee black. Come, beautiful lady. I've gone to all this trouble. You said you liked coffee. Please, sit. Just for a minute. And then I won't bother you anymore, I promise.
I'm holding you to your word, Yusuf.
You remember my name. I must have made an impression.
Just one cup, and then I'm gone. For good.
You have a choice. Turkish. Or maple flavor. I was in Boston last month, and drove up to Montreal. The Canucks, that's what they call Canadians, eat maple like we eat sugar. They harvest sap from the maple trees. I like maple. Tastes good. Different. Here. Try. MABRUKA.
How do you know my name?
You don't remember me. Your father, Feliknas, would take you to my uncle's shop to service his car. You would come and you'd ask so many questions, like how does a carburetor work? What makes the wheels turn? You were so curious. My poor uncle. The truth is you probably knew more about cars than he. You should be an engineer.
If I wasn't born a girl.
Lucky for me you were.
I have to go.
Wait. I'm sorry. That was rude. It's just, I never forgot you. Though I had forgotten your name. When I saw you the other day looking so grown up. So beautiful. I had to ask.
You made inquiries about me. In the village.
How dare you? Do you have any idea what can happen to me? I'm Yazidi and you're...
A Muslim, Sunni, but in name only. I'm a student of all religions, actually. That's why I'm so attracted to Yazidi. You have the best of all religions. Islam, Judaism, Christianity, Buddhism, Zoroastrianism. I love the Sufi aspect. At your festivals, the men twirl and dance into a trance.
If my family finds out I'm talking to a Muslim boy...
A man, even worse. But you can say you were catching up with a childhood friend.
I don't remember you, though you know me.
Don't worry. I was discreet, and my business is a necessity. So good? Please. Come. Sit. Enjoy. There's something I need to explain. It's not me you need to fear.
What do you mean?
Drink your coffee. You crave caffeine, yes? Do you taste the maple?
You still didn't answer my question.
I will. Let's not rush. I'm thinking fondly of Canada. I must say, though, customs is such a pain, they ask so many questions.
My head spun like a spool of yarn that is accidentally dropped and furiously unwinds as it rolls down the street. I was afraid of following the string.
The kitab is in there. Book of Revelations. The black book that contains the tales of the Yazidi history. Bestsellers for sure. Still, they let you learn about your religion when someone taught you to read, MABRUKA. Not bad for a Yazidi girl.
Woman.
Woman.
My father appealed to Sami, our village's religious leader, to teach me.
For a price, I'm sure.
I'm a good student. That's what Sami, my cousin, who's also our new Mukhtar, says. There's so much I want to learn.
Maybe I could teach you. And you, me, my motorcycle's acting up. Should we take a look at the engine? Romeo and Juliet. Shakespeare. You speak English.
I bought it in the market. I don't understand a word of English. But I heard of Shakespeare. And I want people to think I'm worldly and cultured, so I carry around the book.
As daylight doth a lamp arise in heaven, and through the airy regions streams have brought. birds do sing and think it were not night. You have no clue what that means to you. I will translate so you can understand. Romeo thinks Juliet's beauty is even more powerful than the sun. It can make birds think the night is over. And they start singing.
You speak English?
French, Italian, German, Russian, Arabic, Kurdish. In my line of work, it's the cachet of doing business.
What is your business?
So many questions. Can I trust you to keep my secrets?
Will you keep mine?
Touché. That means clever in French. I'm a jack of all trades, mainly a peddler. Peddler of dreams, Mukul. I help men make their dreams come true and make a little profit in the bargain. Do you have dreams, Mabruka?
I'm not a man.
Women have dreams too. Even Yazidi women. I know you were born to do more than just be a domestic slave to your husband someday and push out his babies. Besides, you're a terrible cook.
What do you know about my cooking?
To be a good cook, you have to be adventurous. You refuse my caviar. Imagine we are guests of a Russian oligarch sitting at his dasha, supping on caviar on the Black Sea coast. Close your eyes. You're peeking.
Oh, I wish I could travel for real. There are so many places I want to see. My father and my cousin keep me close. Just Lalish, not far away.
Ah, your pilgrimage to the tomb of Sheikh Adi, the Yazidi founder. I've heard it's quite a celebration. Maybe I should see
you. It's forbidden, not for strangers.
We're no longer strangers. Exchange names, drank coffee, ate caviar, journeyed with Shakespeare to Russia. His, but thy name that is my enemy is because I have a Muslim name. That's why I'm an enemy.
It's not your name, Yusuf. It's a good name. But if you know Yazidis, you know we don't mix with strangers. You're dangerous.
I'm dangerous. I'm flirting with a devil worshipper.
That's a myth. I would have thought a cultured man like you who travels the world would know better, Yusuf. My cousin warned me about Muslims. He was right. Muslim dog. The testimony of my faith is one God. Sultan Sheikh Adi is my king. Sultan Yezid is my king. Tawus Malek is the object of my declaration and my faith. I was saying the afternoon Navaja Ivari, one of our 5 daily prayers, and facing the sun, when Sami's wicked face blocked my light.
Let me ask you, Mabruka. If you were reincarnated, as we say, Kiras, Kuhurin, the changing of the guard, would you come back, Yazidi?
Yazidi is the only faith I know, Sami. I hated when Sami would interrogate me and devour me with his hungry, dark eyes. I tried not to look at him. He reminded me of an ape. Instead, I was the one caged as his student, a frequent object of his fury. I would have fought back, but my father insisted I be civil, especially when Sami was a guest in our house, which was becoming all too frequent. My father couldn't say no. I think he feared Sami's religious fervour. A thin cover for his lust.
A diplomatic answer, but not necessarily the right answer. You could charm my late father, Mabruka. benevolent fool. But I am now Mukhtar, and I must insist on a higher standard.
Especially from you. Eve, you think you can tempt me?
I hate you!
And I'm not the only one you hate.
But you're still a child. And must learn the right path, Mabruka.
It's not easy being Yazidi. Isolated, bound by so many taboos, designed to protect us from the forces of evil. The universe is marshaled to test us. A beautiful girl could be tempted.
The testimony of my faith is one God. Sultan Sheikh Ali is my king. Sultan Yazid is my king. Tawus Malak is the object of my declaration and my faith.
Do you know what the word extinction means, Marco?
You're hurting me, Sami.
Because you're hurting our people. As Yazidis, we must remain pure or we will cease to be. We have suffered 74 genocides at the hands of Muslims and Christians. 1,000 years of persecution. Now Saddam's lawless thugs. The Sunnis are the greatest threat to our existence. Trust no Muslim.
But can't we trace our origins to Islam? Don't we have much in common with Muslims, Jews, Christians and others? Is there not one God for all of us?
We are different. We alone believe that God has moved on and left Taus Melek, the peacock angel, the chief of God's 7 holy beings, to rule the world in his stead.
Muslims and Christians have the audacity to say our peacock angel is Satan. Have I not taught you anything?
You taught me fear.
I saw you flirting with that Muslim boy, like a snake coiling around your soul. Did you let him take a bite of your apple, Eve? Did he touch you?
He didn't touch me, Sami. And besides, he's ignorant. He thinks we're devil worshippers.
If the shoe fits, Mabruka. I will not argue with you.
Maybe you need time to contemplate your sins.
Yazidis don't really believe in evil. But if we did, Sami would be its face. I drew comfort from the knowledge that the sins we sow in this life are harvested in the next. I fantasized about Sami being reincarnated as a woeful donkey.
Oh. Oh.
And then Yusuf intruded on my fantasies. Wasn't he an ass too? Didn't he insult my people? Called us devil worshippers? How can you smear a whole race? Men, they're all ignorant. Especially Yazidi men. I'm not a slave. I'm a human being. A proud woman. I have a value beyond my ability to cook clean and make babies. I should be able to live free. What if my father and Sami didn't like it? Well, too bad. What can they do? Banish me? Well, then I'd be free to choose the life I want. I could go to school. Maybe become an engineer. Dance. Instead, I'm doing penance.
whilst contemplating my sins. Well, I'm finished contemplating. Sammy! You promised to stay away.
It's like promising not to breathe, my dear Mabruka. Would you prefer I turn blue, the forbidden colour? Live your life in fear, Mabruka.
I'm not afraid.
Delicate hands like these aren't meant for scrubbing. It's a sin.
Now you're talking like Sammy.
The ape man. These Yazidis must be pure. Or we will not survive. Silly girl, I will teach you the way. Look and learn! Stay clear of Muslims, all outsiders. Peacocks hate them. They walk on all fours, but they're all dogs. Say your prayers 5 times a day. Wear the right colours. Eat the right foods. Only the purest foods.
Engineering in Germany.
Why not London? Or Paris or America?
Or Canada. I like maple.
So I hear. The whole village knows about you and the Muslim boy. Nothing happened.
I told Sammy. It was over before it started.
Is it?
Yes.
You know we have no money for travel abroad, let alone an education. All you need is here. You should have been grateful to learn how to read the prayers. You didn't take them to heart. Maybe because it was too full.
Nothing happened.
You've started taking an interest in your clothes. I caught you ironing them for the first time.
Haven't you ever been in love, Mother? It wasn't what I expected. Of course, I wasn't expecting to fall in love, and maybe I haven't. I just know that the attention of a man makes me feel warm inside. And he's good looking. Mysterious. He invites me to open strange doors that must stay shut. But what if there's love inside?
There's no room for foolish love. Maybe over many years you learn how to love a man. I was just 14 when my father arranged my marriage to Feleknas. We were both of the peer caste. His family provided a good dowry, including this stove. He lets me speak my mind. In private. I got used to his snoring. I cover his mouth and make him breathe through his nose. He gave me you and your sister Zara without too many tries. We have enough wood and kerosene to cook and keep the house warm. Enough food, clothes, and a above all, honour.
But you never got to go to school or travel,
except for festivals.
You mean I'm a kept woman? As if I had a choice. How did you get to be so free, daughter?
I keep telling your father it's time he gave you away. Maybe then you'd grow up and free your heart for what's important. Sammy has expressed interest.
He's the village mukhtar and a holy man. You could do worse. Sonny's the devil. He beats me.
For your own good.
Better Sammy beats you than the Sunni swine. He's trying to protect you, Mabruka.
And who will protect me from Sammy?
You, father.
Careful! Perhaps I should do to your mouth what I do to your father's. Sammy is powerful.
He chooses you.
I don't choose him.
You don't get to choose.
Nothing settled, but your father and Sammy have been talking. Oh, my girl.
You don't think I wish a better life for you? It's not easy being an Yazidi woman.
So I've been told.
But we survive.
Yazidi women are strong. Stronger than our men, but we can't tell them that. For fear they'll beat us.
Not at all. And in their own way, they love us.
Did you know, at each New Year's festival, your father gives me a colored egg he made with a little gift inside? No, not egg yolk. Sometimes it's a pretty stone or a poem on a piece of paper he reads to me. He didn't do these things at first. He learned. We learned.
Sammy can't learn. He's an ape. Your words are weighted with stones. He'll drag you down to hell, Mabruka.
If you were to even touch this Muslim man, you'd no longer be a part of our family. And if you were to marry him, then you'd no longer be an Yazidi. You'd be Muslim. But his family will reject you as an infidel, and so will his other wives.
Yusuf's not married.
You know this for a fact.
Where does Yusuf live?
He didn't say. Probably with his uncle in the village, who fixed his father's car.
Your father fixes his own car.
But he said...
Men say lots of things to pretty girls.
Well, he doesn't have to say he loves me because I know.
Oh, foolish girl! With men, there's little difference between love and lust. Look at you, so young and beautiful. But to survive as an Yazidi woman, you must hide your beauty, lest our enemies devour you. Perhaps then your Yusuf would lose interest. I don't want to lose my precious daughter, Mabruka. But tradition comes first. There's a fine line. Don't cross it. Yawus Malek. Have pity on your poor servant. I deserve better than this. My parents think I'm headstrong for questioning authority. Isn't that how we learn? I mean no disrespect. I follow all the rules handed down by my ancestors without question, though I don't understand why I can't eat lettuce. I'm proud to be Yazidi. But are we not all equal descendants of Adam?
Adam was the first Muslim, the father of the human race.
Go away!
Whoa! Take it easy, girl!
Haven't you done me enough harm?
That depends on how you define harm. I've had to be a bit more careful since I fired a shot and nicked that pointy too. You think it was a declaration of war? I have eyes on me everywhere. Strangers asking questions.
Like how you lied about your uncle fixing my father's car.
I saw you staring at my motorcycle's two-stroke engine and figured you had a mechanical bend, so I improvised. No, my uncle didn't have an auto repair shop. He was a tailor. And that was my home. That's the truth. Sometimes I stretch it out so much that it tears, but I have my reasons.
I don't want to know anything about you. Not even your real name.
Brought you a book. Mem and Zin by the poet Ahmed Khan. Have you heard of it? They call it the Kurdish Romeo and Juliet. Khan wrote it in the 17th century. Like Romeo and Juliet, it's the tale of lovers from different clans who meet the tragic end when their families deny their love. I thought you'd like to read it.
Sammy took away my books. He forbids me to read or learn. Instead, I have to work the field like a donkey.
I thought you were fearless, Mabruka.
I'm not stupid. Leave me alone. Go. Off to Canada or wherever you go.
Soon enough. Mosul is getting too hot for me. Since the fall of Saddam, there's a power vacuum. If one is not careful, one can get sucked into it.
I have my own problems.
Easily solved. You want to continue learning, Mabruka? How about dancing? Would you dance with me? I will teach you.
Haven't you taught me enough? I'm not a dog. I don't need to be taught any tricks.
What if I provided you a tutor to teach you? A secret tutor. And no charge. He can teach you everything you wanted to know, but were too afraid to ask. Siri. Why don't the Yazidis eat lettuce?
The caliphs of the Ottoman Empire carried out many massacres against the Yazidis in the 18th and 19th centuries, with thousands of them killed in the lettuce fields then dotting northeastern Iraq. Watching the blood of innocents gush into the greens prompted a lasting aversion to the vegetable.
Siri will teach you everything, including English. You can watch the news in America and England, listen to music, play games.
How about the truth about why Yazidis don't eat lettuce? Yes, my people have long been persecuted. But the ban against lettuce goes back further than the Ottomans. In the 13th century, a ruthless ruler near here ordered the execution of one of our saints. The people pelted his corpse with lettuce heads. Since then, it's forbidden to eat lettuce.
You hear that, Siri? We stand corrected. Still, all the knowledge of the world, true or not, is in this song. Accept all that which which is not written down. And I'm giving it to you, Mabruka, so you can live and learn. Siri, play the song Somewhere Over the Rainbow by the singer Iz. Then she's mapping!
Like you.
I can take a hint. I won't bother you anymore. My solemn word. If I had my own copy of the Quran, I would swear on it. Turns out I must leave now. For business. I don't know if I'll return, Mabruka. Depends on where the winds of opportunity take me. But it would give me great comfort to think of you exploring the world with Siri. Just don't track me down. I've deleted my call log. It's like I never existed.
I wish.
Don't tell anyone how you got this phone or anything about me. I trust no one. I'm gonna leave you a power bank and a charger.
Had I sinned? You could argue I'm forbidden to even converse with strangers, let alone accept gifts. But isn't it equally sinful not to grow the mind God bless me with? To strive for knowledge I could share to bring about greater understanding and acceptance for my people. But Siri opened up the world to me. Like a magic carpet, she flew me far beyond the Badush and Achin Mountains and the Tigris River to bathe in English rain, sup along the Champs-Élysées, ring the Liberty Bell, and drink maple-flavoured coffee in Ottawa. I even stowed away on the Apollo spaceship and landed on the moon. Sami insists the Yazidis are the centre of the universe. More like he is. But Sami's stupid. I know better. I even now know how a two-stroke motorcycle engine works. It's amazing what you can learn on YouTube. Fashion, beauty secrets, recipes. I surprised my mother when I made lasagna. She prefers her own cooking, probably because I burned it. I was too busy with Siri. Everything you wanted to know but were afraid to ask is at your fingertips. Especially music. I listen to everything. Pop, jazz, rock and roll, country, opera. Maria Callas singing Madam Butterfly. Her voice makes my heart flutter. And yes, I search Shakespeare. Siri beckoned me to explore, to question my beliefs. And I questioned everything. I even discovered Twitter. So much desperation and hatred in my world. The currents are bubbling to the surface. Jihad, Islamic fervor. Should I warn the others? Would they listen to a young woman? Even one as worldly as I? Would they mock me as Eve? Well,
I don't regret taking a bite of the apple. But just like Eve in the Garden of Eden, I couldn't wait to share.
Come on, Mabruka! I need to check Nicky's latest tweets!
You're obsessed with Nick Jonas, Sarah. I don't even like his music.
Speak for yourself. Nicky's so cute. I'm in love. Are you in love, Mabruka?
More like in hate.
Then what are this boy's photos doing in your phone?
I told you, I found his phone, now it's mine, and that's not a boy. That's a man.
He's not as good looking as Nick Jonas.
He's attractive enough.
He looks cocky,
confident.
He has big lips.
Broad shoulders.
I bet he has a lisp.
No, he doesn't.
Ma!
So you know him.
You ask too many questions, Zara. Maybe I already know the answers.
I'm begging you. This is a secret.
You mustn't tell. Otherwise, Siri will never talk to you again.
No.
I won't tell. For a price. I knew I shouldn't have trusted you.
I don't have any money, you know that.
I like your green sweater. I embroidered that myself. Excellent handiwork. I admire it so. And I'm sure Nikki will find me especially ravishing if I was wearing it.
Talk about cocky.
Has he kissed you? In your dreams, maybe? Like I kiss Nikki?
Stop it. You have no idea about what I feel or don't feel for him.
Yusuf?
Shh!
How do you know his name?
What does Yusuf do?
He wouldn't say. So mysterious.
And dangerous.
Have you checked his call log?
Who does Yusuf talk to when he's not talking to you?
He never calls me. The call feature's blocked.
Figures. Is he married?
No. I mean, I don't know.
Do you even know where Yusuf lives?
He grew up around Mosul. An uncle still lives here. But now, Yusuf lives everywhere. All the places I want to go.
That's you, Mabruka. Where was it taken? Not around here.
I don't know who that is or where that photo was taken.
Liar.
She's wearing dark blue, a sin. Plus she has short hair, I have long hair, can't you see?
You're prettier.
You think so?
Now he's asking too many questions. But you should know, sister. I'm not the only one asking questions.
You're scaring me.
Your boyfriend is scaring me.
Shh! He's not my boyfriend. You say things like that, Zara, you could get me in big trouble. Just guard your tongue.
You, met him?
Yusuf met me. He was a little creepy. I asked him why he was asking about you. He said he couldn't help himself. He fell in love with you at first sight and had to learn all about you and Yazidis. He acted crazy. Said he would convert if it would please you. Well, I told him he can't. To be Yazidi, both your parents must be. That didn't stop Yusuf. When I hinted he was working for the Kurdish police, he said, fine, he'll make inquiries in the village. I can let him do that. So I offered to share. A little. In exchange, Yusuf had to tell me all about himself. if you wanted my approval.
And who are you to approve?
Little Jinna!
Stop!
I asked if Yusuf was his real name. Yes. Yusuf Abdullah Yassin. He grew up a few kilometers from here. His father was a Sunni imam. A holy man like Sunni. Yusuf didn't mention an uncle. When I asked him what he did for a living, he changed the subject. At one point, he offered me Cadbury chocolates. From England.
And?
I ate them.
Oh. Delicious.
I know it's taboo to accept food from strangers.
You couldn't resist.
Look who's talking. Yusuf asked if you had ever had a boyfriend.
Huh?
I told him you were a virgin and had never been kissed.
What?
Don't be mad. I got your back, Mabruka.
Oh, kicking my butt! How dare you!
I get the sense that Yusuf wanted you to find that picture of your lookalike, Mabruka. He knew you'd look. He said you reminded him of someone. Someone very pure who would light up his life when darkness fell.
It sounds like a passage from Romeo and Juliet.
Oh yes. Yusuf's quite the poet. And I know who Shakespeare is. Ceres, my friend too.
They killed his family.
What?
Who?
We did. Or so Yusuf claims.
Some kind of land dispute. Yusuf said the Yazidis approached Saddam Mukbarat's secret police. They arrested his father and brothers while they were praying.
Then later came for his mother and sisters. He never saw them again. And now he has no interest in religion.
Except ours.
He has a hidden reason. I'm sure.
Remind me of Sammy. Everyone has a hidden agenda.
Yusuf was in the army.
He deserted when he heard that his family had been executed. But soon after Saddam fell and the Americans disbanded the Iraqi army, so no one came looking for him.
He fled the country.
But he came back. Did he say why?
Did I tell you how much I love Nick Jonas?
I eat cheese, but only on pizza, please. And sometimes on a homemade quesadilla. Otherwise.
I was haunted by a ghost. It had been 3 months since I'd heard from Yusuf. Not a word. Maybe he took the hint to leave me alone. Or maybe he believed I wasn't really interested, but how could he not see the truth? Or maybe he met a more willing woman on his travels, one he wouldn't have to work so hard to woo. But she wouldn't have been nearly as fun or alluring. Where could he be?
I should be with Yusuf,
experiencing all
stay. I'm here. My sister, Zara. Watching Mary Poppins. Have you any idea what the lyric supercalifragilisticexpialidocious sounds like in translation? Needless to say, I wasn't paying rapt attention to the movie. My thoughts meandered off screen to Yusuf and back. So at first, I didn't notice the action flickering in the shadows.
I was focused on stealing Zara's popcorn. Get your own popcorn, Mabruka! No, first, you lied to me about what movie you were going to see. You promised me a classic! I thought we were seeing Nick Jonas in Camp Rock. But instead, I have to sit through this trick. You're not even paying attention!
It's because I'm hungry, come on, share!
No. No, don't touch my... Just bond with it. Just bond with me.
Scream, Mabruka, it's me, Yusuf. I just want to talk to you. I won't hurt you, trust me. I'll just move my hand if you promise not to scream, okay?
Father!
Shh! Your parents are not home. Zara is sound asleep. Please, I came here to warn you. Just listen.
Have you no shame? You can't be in a maiden's bedroom.
My cover's blown. The authorities are searching for me. It's not safe for you either. That Sunni gorilla is claiming you're in bed with me.
What are you talking about? I don't hear from you for months and then you slip me a rose and now you sneak into my bedroom. This is madness.
I didn't mean to do that. Well, I did, but that's not why I came here. I'm in trouble, Mabruka.
What kind of trouble and what has it got to do with me?
Where's my phone?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
My sister may have borrowed it.
What? Didn't I tell you not to let anyone know about the phone? Was I talking to myself?
You've been talking in my head for months, Yusuf. I've missed you. Where did you go? Why didn't you write?
When it rains, it pours.
I don't understand.
It's an English proverb. Means when a bad thing happens, usually more bad things follow. I've had my share of bad luck this summer. I couldn't contact you, Mabruka. I wasn't safe. You play chess? Did Siri teach you?
My father.
Ah. Well, the old fool is good for something after all.
I beg your pardon?
Men are in motion. They're moving quickly, propelled by forces you don't understand.
I'm following Twitter, I know.
You know nothing. You're just a girl. An innocent girl.
Until you changed me.
If I could only change you back.
It's too late. The cork's been popped. You liberated me, Yusuf. I'm afraid.
free woman. I fear nothing. Not my father, not Sammy, not you.
I'm sorry. Please forgive me. There's no excuse for my rude behaviour. I came here because I care deeply about you. I missed you too.
You have a strange way of showing it.
Oh, well, these are strange times. They bring out the worst in men. Look at me.
I am.
I'm wondering what you're doing in my bedroom. My parents will be home soon. Zara's probably gone to fetch them. They're praying for Sammy.
I don't want to leave you here, Mabruka, but I have to get out of Iraq now. I would take you with me.
You know I can't go. Will you come back to me?
You know the answer to that. That voice. From the American Southwest. Silver Wolf. An American Indian I befriended in Arizona gave it to me. I won't tell you what I did for him, but he said he was my spiritual grandfather. A lot of Americans think there are Indian grandfathers watching over them, but there isn't enough Indian blood in this land to grandfather them all. It doesn't matter. Indians believe turquoise protects you from evil. Take it. Even if you don't believe, Mabruka, know that I will protect you. With this rock, my gift to you, I give you my word and my heart.
Yazidis don't like blue.
Oh, yes, you prefer red. How uncouth of you. I'm still learning, Mabruka. You have so many customs and superstitions.
It's who we are. Thank you, Yusuf.
Hensi, Mahab. Well, Hensi. In Arabic, it means...
You're welcome. Siri taught me.
I wish I could teach you.
But you're on the run. And you still haven't told me why.